Recently, I introduced you to the dangers of deep vein thrombosis. So in this video, I would like to talk about a presumably rare condition by the name of Mondor's disease. This is a thrombosis of superficial veins. Why could this be of interest? Because it can affect the penis. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. In contrast to deep vein thrombosis, your life is not in danger in Mondor's disease. In technical terms, we would call it a thrombophlebitis of the dorsal superficial vein of the penis. Phlebitis refers to the inflammation of a vein, by the way. So, what can you expect? Usually, pain on the upper side of your penis, and sometimes the skin may develop a reddish color around the dorsal vein. The vein itself becomes very visible, and when you touch it, it is hard, like the long version of an uncooked macaroni, which is called a bucatini. The pain may get worse with erections. Sometimes there are no symptoms at all. However, be careful not to rush to a self-diagnosis because this is a rare condition, yet most presumably underreported in the literature. I have seen 2 cases during the past 5 years. What are risk factors for penile Mondor's disease? It can be prolonged and rough sexual intercourse, penile trauma, local infections, sexually transmitted infections, complications of local surgical procedures like hernia repair, or ligation of a varicocele, which is a benign enlargement of veins adjacent to the spermatic cord. Then there is the application of intracavernous drugs, bodybuilding exercises, cancer in the pelvic region, a general tendency for thrombosis, and others. The good news is that in most cases, it will resolve by itself without any treatment within 2 months. Until then, it is recommended that you abstain from any sexual activity. Often, heparin cream is prescribed for application onto the penile skin and anti-inflammatory drugs such as ibuprofen. However, in the unlikely event that the thrombus is not resolving after having given it enough time and symptoms are still present, surgical removal of the blood clot becomes an option. In assessing Mondor's disease, palpation is important, but color Doppler ultrasound imaging is crucial. This special imaging technique uses the Doppler effect to measure flow in blood vessels. Okay, what's the Doppler effect? Here's a demonstration of the sound of an ambulance going past my office. Did you notice the change in pitch as it drives by? This change is due to the Doppler effect. We make use of it in color Doppler ultrasound by making blood flow visible with color, if there is any. Now comes the most important part of this video. I would like to remind you not to rush to any conclusions regarding your own penis. Mondor's disease is rare, and apart from that, we have mainly 2 other diseases with a similar appearance. It's Peyronie's disease. If you've never heard about it, check out this playlist, and sclerosing lymphangitis. This is another uncommon benign disease of the penis. If you want to know more about it, check out this video. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.